name is Emi Kokaji. International Sales Manager from Nikka. Today I will give a presentation on the new product, which is a coffee pen. Are you familiar with the green whiskey? Do you drink a lot of green whiskey? No, not so. So green whiskey is made from the variety of common grains such as corn, wheat, rye. And the green whiskey is distilled in a continuous collapse still. And it is normally used for blended whiskey. Let's have a look at the production method of the grain whiskey. So first, we steam the corn in this case, and they put some malted barley to get the enzyme for mashing. Then fermentation and distillation, but in a continuous still. Then aging in flasks. On the other hand, malt whiskey production is slightly different. Of course, the ingredients need malt, and this is in the pot still. So Nikka coffee blend is made from American corn, and this is in the coffee stills, which we have in Miyagi-kyo distillery. And the coffee blend is very important for Nikka, because it is a key component of Nikka's blended whiskey, such as from the barrel and the tea. And now Nikka coffee blend is bottled on its own as Nikka coffee blend. So Nikka launched the first time in Europe. Nikka launched coffee blend for the first time in Europe in September 2012. And just after the launch, we got the gold medal at the International Spirit Challenge this year. Then we introduced this product in Japan in June. Then we are expanding its market into the US. And the Nikka coffee blend is coming to Singapore, maybe at the end of November. So the secret behind the Nikka coffee blend is the coffee stills we have. What is a coffee grain? The coffee grain is named after Ineos Cafe, an Irish scientist who developed this steel and patented this steel in 1830. This is a very old traditional steel and very difficult to operate to maintain. So that's for the coffee steel to require the skilled plasma. Maybe it might be a disadvantage of coffee steel. Nikka still use the old steel because the spirit distilled in the coffee steel retain more flavor than other modern continuous steel. So Masataka Taketsuru imported the coffee steel from Scotland. The first steel was imported in 1963 and the second one in 1966. And first those two sets of coffee steel were used to be in Nishinomiya plant, but it relocated from Nishinomiya to Miyagi-kyo in 1999. And now Nikka has two sets of coffee steel in the Miyagi-kyo. So the Miyagi-kyo produces both malt whiskey and green whiskey. This is the map of Japan and then, now, it was, they were relocated to the Miyagi-kyo. This is a wide scenery of Miyagi-kyo. And the steel house is there. This is also Miyagi-kyo. This is a steel house. Very tall building, with 5 stories. Of the overall coffee steel because it is too large, very tall. And this is the first set of the steel which was imported in 1963. So So it was made by the Scottish company in Glasgow. This is Masataka Taketsuru, as you know, the founder of Nikka. He is the first Japanese who went to Scotland and learned whiskey making and brought the technique back to Japan. He thought there were four essential factors for his idea of whiskey. The first one is the location, which is similar to Scotland. That's why Masataka chose Yoichi and Miyagi-kyo in the northern part of Japan. And second one is a variety of malt whiskey. We have two distilleries which produce a different, totally different type of malt whiskey. And the grain whiskey is another key for his ideal whiskey. And of course, the blend skill is most important to make a good whiskey. So Masataka thought the coffee still is critical for his blended whiskey. From 1980 to 1920. So first he enrolled at Glasgow University, then had an apprenticeship at the three distilleries. Among them, he learned how to operate a coffee still and how to make a coffee grain whiskey at the James Powder. So now you have a coffee blend if you just be from Japan, just taste together. May I ask some comments?